Hello everyone. We just conducted an experiment on WLAN Layer 2 bypass networking. Now, let's look at the WLAN Layer 3 bypass networking experiment. Layer 3 bypass networking means that our AUIC and AP are not in the same Layer 2 network. This networking method allows for more flexible placement of the AUIC and a more flexible network topology. Now, let's see how this type of network is configured. Firstly, the topology is similar to that of the Layer 2 bypass network. Now let's look at our experimental plan. We still have these three interfaces on the core switch. There is a VLAN 50, which is our connection between the core switch and our router. The GE002 is a trunk interface. It carries VLAN 20 and 60. And GE003 connects to our access switch from the core switch. Here, we carry VLAN 10 and 30. Similarly, in our access switch, we are using VLAN 10 and 30. In our AC, we are using VLAN 20 and 60. Here is our IP address plan. On the router, we have an IP address, 10.1.5, with a 24-bit mask. On our core switch, we've created some logical VLAN interfaces. These are VLAN 10, 20%, 30, as well as 50 and 60, each corresponding to different subnets. On our AC, we have two addresses, one in VLAN 60, which is 10.1.6 with a 24-bit mask, and another in WLAN 0, which is 10.10 with a 32-bit mask. So this is our data planning. Our core switch acts as the DHCP server, assigning IPP addresses to our APs and users. That is, our core switch also serves as the gateway for APs and users. Our AP's address pool ranges from 10.1.10.2 to 10.1.10.254. The address pool for users is divided into two parts. The pool for employees is in the 10.1.20% segment, and for customers, it's in the 10.1.30 segment. And the source address for our AYC interface is loopback 0. Similarly, our AP group, named Huawei, needs to reference the VAP template and the domain management template. The domain management template, also named Huawei, has the country code set to CN. Then, in the SSID template, there are two names, one for employees and one for customers. For the security template, under the employee's name, we used a security policy. Under customers, our security policy is open system. Lastly, the VAP template. For the VAP template, for employees, we use tunnel forwarding mode. For customers, we use direct forwarding. Let's now look at the specific configurations. The configuration approach is still first to set up network intercommunication. Second step, configure AP online. Third step, configure WLAN service. First, let's configure IP intercommunication. Since we had configurations on our equipment before, when we were conducting experiment 3, there were some configurations on the device. Before configuring, we need to clean up the configurations. First, we enter the core switch, go into the system output. We now need to add a few VLANs. VLAN addition is complete. Next, we need to configure the ports. First, the first port. Let's look at the original configuration. The original configuration is access default VLAN 30. Now we need to change it to default VLAN 50. Since the access port only supports one VLAN, so we just need to input part default VLAN 50 again to overwrite the previous default VLAN 30 command. Now let's display it. It is now changed to default VLAN 50. Next, we configure the second interface. the second interface, connects to our AYC device. It needs to allow VLAN 20 and 60 to pass through. Entering the second interface, our current configuration is allowing VLAN 10 to pass through. First, we need to disable VLAN 10. We use undo port trunk, allow pass VLAN 10. This way, VLAN 10 is disabled. Then, we need to allow VLAN 20 and 60 to pass through. Now, we have allowed VLAN 20 and 60 to pass through. Next, let's look at the third interface. We can enter using G003. Previously, we allowed VLAN 10 and 20% to pass through. Now we need to cancel VLAN 20 and add VLAN 30. Now let's display it. Now we are allowing VLAN 10 and 30 to pass through. Okay, we have completed VLAN pass through on the core switch. Finally, don't forget to save. Next, let's look at the configuration on the second switch. Enter the configuration interface. First, we need to enable VLAN 10 and VLAN 30. Next, we need to enter G0-0-1 to allow VLAN 10 to pass through. At the same time, we need to set our PVID to VLAN 10. Then, allow VLAN 10 and VLAN 30 to pass through. First, let's look at the previous configuration. Previously, VLAN 10 was already set as PVID. Now we just need to cancel VLAN 20 and add VLAN 30. Operation completed. Let's move on to the second interface. The second interface is the same as the third interface. Cancel VLAN 20 and add VLAN 30. Operation completed. Next, we proceed with operations on the AC. Similarly, do not forget to save. We use AC2 connected to our core switch. Let's take a look at the specific configurations on AC2. First, let's look at the ports used on AC2. Our AC2's G0-1 is connected to the second port of our core switch. Now, we operate on 0-01. Currently, our device allows VLAN 10 to pass through, but we need to allow VLAN 20 and 60 to pass through. First, we need to establish these two VLANs, 20% and 60. Next, enter G0-1. After deleting VLAN 10, allow VLAN 20 and VLAN 60 to pass through. Operation completed. Next, we need to configure IP and routing information on the device to ensure our network interconnectivity, starting with the core switch. After entering VLAN 10, we need to set an IP address for VLAN 10. Now, our VLAN 10 has an IP address. Similarly, we set up VLAN 20. IP address can be abbreviated as IPADD. Next is VLAN 30, then lastly, VLAN 50 and VLAN 60. Note, here it is 10.1.50.2, because 10.1.50.1 we need to configure on our router. Next is VLAN 60, also 10.1.60.2, because 10.1 we need to configure on the AC. Core switch configuration is complete. Next, we proceed with AC configuration. First, configure interface VLAN 60. VLAN if 60, then add IPADD 10.60.1. Next, configure interface loopback 0. Configure loopback interface 0. Note, the loopback interface uses a 32-bit mask. Configuration complete. You can save. Next step is to configure destination addresses on R1 for static routes for user segments, and also need to configure IP addresses. First, we need to enter G001. Previously, we had other configurations. Now we need to delete them. Then reconfigure the IP address. Configuration successful. Next, we need to configure two static routes, 10.1.2.0.0 and 10.1.3.0.0. Packets destined for these two addresses need to be sent to 10.1.50.2. Configuration complete, you can save. Now let's test it. If it pings successfully, it means our configuration is correct.